a trail again and again. Hiking and hunting and fishing the land. Time is time we'll spend. We'll take it to the delta.
Mississippi outdoors.
When the kids first get here, first of all, the first thing you see is they're smiles and enjoyment. They're smiling before they even get to me, which I normally work at the registration table. So they get there, they register, then they have a day full of fun. They have fishing, they have a shooting range that they can go target practice. They also normally have like a Santa Claus that will come by and visit and spend time with them, and then have little goodie bags for them. Then all the family and the kids get to sit down, enjoy a meal, and just fellowship together. Then from there, they move on to the next station.
All right, all yours.
The Super Hunt is a deer hunt for youth with disabilities. We take kids anywhere from 6 years of age to 17. And we actually, the Department of Wildlife, years ago, back when it was sponsored by the NWTF, went to the commission and asked if we could have a special weekend just for these kids. And so they granted us permission to hunt the weekend before youth deer season. And so we get kids to participate in a hunt where they can just be a kid for a weekend. They go out to these deer camps, they hang out, they just relax. The parents get to come with them, sometimes a sibling or two, depending on the number of people that are coming with them. But they get to participate in normal hunting activities where they ride four-wheelers, they go look at food plots, they go check out deer, and they go hunting. And so it's a great outdoor event just for the whole family and for kids that may not get the opportunity to do that every day of the year anyway.
Well, we start the day off right. We bring the fishing trailer down here. We have canopies, we have tables, we have all the rods and reels, poles, bait, tackle, but most of all, we have some great big catfish in there for those kids to catch. Oh, the look on their faces was just absolutely amazing. They totally come to life. Out there on the bank, they are as one. Oh, they can be standing there in la la land, as we would say, looking around and watching this and then watching that, and all of a sudden that line of tight, and they go from that to a squealing like teenager, just excitement, jumping all over them. Catching a fish brings joy to everybody's face, and the parents stand there, their smiles are bigger than the kids, you know, and all of us are standing there and we're all rooting. We're like a bunch of cheerleaders that's standing around rooting that child on. And you know, sometimes they have to grab them by the pants because they get so excited, they want to get that fish then. So
oh, the super hunting, it's sometimes it's hard to express it into words. It's so emotional that the actual hunt itself, though, it's a weekend for kids with disabilities, any kind of disability. We've got kids from multiple states coming in, but mostly from Mississippi. And it gives these kids a weekend to be able to experience the deer camp experience. And yes, part of that is hunting, and part of that is harvesting the deer. But it's also the campfire time. It's making s'mores. It's getting to sit out there and grill over the grill and being able to enjoy that. Riding four-wheelers, going out and doing some fishing, going out and doing scouting with these kids. And I think the kids aspect of it is absolutely there, but I think we also throw in the rest of the family too. is that mom, that dad, that brother, that sister, that they get to spend some time with their sibling, maybe in an environment that they don't normally do. And in some cases, they can even have a chance to relax a little bit because they know that their child is being extremely well taken care of by these hunting camps and these guides and these owners of these lands.
Taking them out in the woods is a great joy, but there's a lot of preparatory work that has to go on before they can go out there if you want them to be successful. We revolve around safety, and then we talk about marksmanship, but we want them to be successful on the range. We not only want them to have the weapon sighted in or firearm sighted in, but we want them to actually be able to interface with the firearm so that they can make a successful strike on the animal and make an ethical shot. And that's what the Super Hunt to me is about, is extending opportunities to someone that might not otherwise have an opportunity.
A lot of kids, when they first came, even though we were officers and everything, just we were strangers to them. So we did small talk, joke around with them just to make them lower their guard. Most kids, once they was out for a while and got familiar with us, they relaxed and had a good day.
Get the bulls out.
Truth control will come in.
Yep.
A lot of kids are curious about a firearm, and they're curious about what it does, how it works. And this is a good example, a good way to get them out and actually show them how it works, show them the results of that firearm when it's being used, and what happens after you pull the trigger.
You good? All righty.
Good job. As soon as they got out of the car, they were happy. They were smiling, you know, grinning from ear to ear. And when they got to sit down and talk with us and us actually helped them, it really just made that, you know, made it that much better. Going home and telling your family about it, it was amazing. It truly was. How you doing?
Very rewarding for us to be able to help these kids out and let them have some fun and get them out of their normal routine. And we'll be hunting over a green field. It's got corn still left standing in one end of it where we had corn planted, and it's a good spot. Grayson is going to be in a ground blind that's in the middle of a CRP patch that's got a small food plot in it. And we historically see a lot of deer there. So it's a great, great spot. So, yeah, we tried to plan it out a little bit in advance where it would be perfect for the boys.
What you gonna do this afternoon?
Shoot.
Shoot what?
A deer.
First off, I wanna say I'm glad to have everybody here. We're gonna start putting people out, just 1, 2, 3 right behind each other. Hopefully we're gonna get you out in a good fashion and everybody's gonna hunt safe, have a good hunt. And another thing, don't go to the stand without orange on.
We're just spraying you on, buddy.
Smell good. What do you think about all this, Dad?
Oh, man, it's phenomenal. It's a dream come true, blessing, you know, for what these guys do. So, I mean, it's just a very humbling experience. Very good.
Give me a big growl. How you look down there?
Back it right in that spot. We're gonna put that tent over you, okay? I'm gonna be here with you, buddy. Me and you.
Okay.
he just skirted the edge, and he was looked like he was going to come out, and he heard something, and he turned around and stepped back out, and he gave him a broadside shot facing, well, quartering away. And
we were hunting this afternoon with Grayson here at the CRP stand, and he shot a nice buck, and after looking at the video, we gave him some time. Looks like he hit him, made a good kick, and now we brought a dog, a trailing dog. We're hoping we find him.
Well, we tried for about 20 minutes, 30 minutes, and didn't find no blood, no hair. So, clean mess. That happens. We'll get her tomorrow.
When this event takes place every year, everybody kind of has their own role. Everybody comes together for one main purpose, and that's just to make sure that everybody has a successful hunt. And a successful hunt is not always harvesting an animal. It's getting out and enjoying what God put on this earth for us all to enjoy. That's really what it's all about. It's not always about harvesting a deer or harvesting whatever animal you're hunting. It's the overall experience that makes it a success.
For over 70 years, Mississippi Outdoors magazine has served the readers of the Magnolia State. The magazine contains interesting features such as wildlife photography and solar tables. Subscriptions to the magazine are very inexpensive, and when you subscribe, you'll receive 6 bi-monthly issues containing articles on hunting and fishing in the state, public lakes, state parks, and our wildlife management areas. For more information, call our toll-free number at 1-888-874-5785.
Grenada Lake this morning on a hot crappie day. We're going to be catching crappie today with Brandon Fulgham, and Olivia's going to be my co-angler today. You said that everything's moving?
What's done happened? We done got, you know, well into the month of August now. The core's done turned the spillway on, and we got a lot of current rolling through the lake now, and those fish have been kind of stagnant all summer. And now we got current in the lake and shad up popping. Those fish have just done come alive out there. It'll be a good day.
Let's see if we go catch some crappie.
Let's do it, buddy.
Let's do it. Grenada Lake is on fire. We're gonna catch some of these monster crappie today. We're gonna get it done. Here we go, folks.
She got you, bud.
Here we go, folks. I knew this was gonna happen. Bring him on in. That looks like a good one.
Swing him up here, bud.
Oh, yeah, that's a good fish. Good job.
He's a little short, just by a hair.
11 and 15, 16.
That's about what he was.
So, Miss Olivia, tell me about a big crappie I heard you caught one time.
In January, I caught a fish, and when I pulled it in, it got caught in the trolling motor.
So you got over and you untied him. He turned out to be a big crappie?
Mm-hmm.
Where's he at now?
On the wall.
He's on the wall. The one that didn't get away, huh? How big was he? That long?
Uh-oh.
Oh, he's that long, he said. Uh-oh, Olivia. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, might have a keeper here.
She was quick to say no, wasn't
she? Uh-oh, Olivia, here we go. Could he be? Could he be?
No.
Oh, man.
11 and a half.
Beautiful fish, though. Oh, okay, so now we tied 1-1.
I was still bigger.
You see, it was, yeah, you were that much bigger. I don't know, he may be close.
He's gonna be close.
He can be close. I might have the first one in the box.
Nope.
Oh,
11 and a half.
Are you eating my lunch?
No.
You didn't. I thought you said you was bringing lunch today. We tried this first spot, running one of the spots. You've seen we've got some shorty fish. We're wanting some really good crappie today, so we're going to move across the lake, hit spot number two. Okay. We're just going to bounce around until we get on them.
That's right.
Boy, I ate all her peanut butter wraps one, huh? Might be a keeper, Olivia. I might have you. He ain't to the boat yet, but I think we've got a first keeper of the day right here. It's pretty good fish. This might be just another keeper fish. Oh yeah, oh yeah.
Dip him up for him, Livy.
Good job, Miss Olivia. Good job. Let me help you out. That's a good fish right here. That's a good fish. Look at her. She done grabbed my rod.
She was on that one.
Now Miss Olivia, you supposed to just grab my pole right here and let me reel my fish. Oh, get him. That's a good one, baby. Reel him in. Get him up high. Get him over that other line. Grab your line. Pull him on up in there. Good
there
job.
Goes, Jay.
Good job.
You got one on your other pole. One on your other pole, Livy. Outside pole.
Get him up.
That's
a good one too. Good fish, Miss Olivia. Pretty fish. Get him over the boat. There he is right there. Good job.
Hold him up, Livy. Show the camera.
Hey.
Show him what we do with him.
You don't make me do the Crisco Disco, would you? Oh yeah, that's a good one here.
I got one right here. Ooh. Oh, it's a good one too, Livy.
We hit a jackpot.
It's a big one.
You get the net, boy. Come over here.
Yeah, get the net on this one.
Look at this big old crappie right here, Livy. Look here. Get the net.
Good job. Oh, that's the one I was wanting, Brandon.
There we go.
That is the one we want right there. All right, let's put this one in here, and we're gonna look at this one here. This is the one we want to look at. This is the fish of the day right here. That's a good 2-pound fish. Huh?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. That fish is real heavy in the springtime. Hold it up like. Let's put her on the board here and let's see how long she is. Right at 16 inches.
Oh yeah, this is gonna be a good one here.
Grab a middle pole, Livy. Grab the middle pole.
Middle
Livy.
Pole right here, they got a fish on it.
That's what I'm gonna do.
Todd, just lift him up in there. Oh, you got a good one too, Liv.
Ooh, that's another good one, Brandon.
Yeah.
That's what we taught. That's what we asked. Let me help Miss Olivia with this one. I think he ain't gonna make the team today, Olivia.
Ooh.
He's not gonna make the team, but.
Look at that song right there. Oh my gosh.
Get him in here, Olivia. Get him on top. Get him on top. That's a good fish, darling. That's a good fish. Here, Miss Olivia, grab this. Grab your fish. Hold it up for everybody to see your fish you just caught. Look at that. That is a beautiful crappie. That's a good one.
She's
telling me to get the net. I am her official net man today.
I've done you 3 times.
Good job, good job. Take your net and go turn that way with it.
Oh, he swallowed it.
Yeah.
We should be looking at my poles over here now. Oh yeah, that's a keeper there.
Real, don't let him have fight real.
That's a good fish.
I don't believe she's getting you on them keepers.
I think she's got me. You want to switch sides? Come on, I'll give you $1 to switch sides with me. No chance. Well, I guess I'm going to have to give you the old boot overboard then. We caught about 10 nice ones. We probably had about 10 or 15 throwbacks. We want some big keeper fish, so we're going to go to spot. Which one? Outside? Outside, right. Keeper here. Yeah, I think he's gonna make the cut. Oh yeah, he's close.
12 and a quarter.
Okay.
There you go.
Yeah, get him on top. That's a big one. Don't lose him. Oh yeah, that's a box fish, believe you. That's a good one. One more for cooler. Good job.
Libby, outside pole. Outside pole, Libby. Well, that's a big
that's
one,
a
Libby.
Good one.
That's a big one, Libby. There we go.
Goodness gracious, that's what we're looking for right there. That's, here, hold this pole, Libby.
Now, that lady, gentleman, is a
give me something right here on that. I like it. I like it. I think we have a future making him a female professional crappie fisherman. What do you think? Oh, he's gonna make a traveling team, I believe. That's a good one there, man. Good one. Reel down on it some more. Reel down on some more. Let's help you up. Good job. Look at that one. That is a nice one, Olivia. Man, won't you let me catch some of these big ones like this? You better give me that ice chest. Nope, he's gonna be a keeper. Without a doubt. Beautiful. Beautiful.
Old summertime crappie.
Grenada Lake, baby. You love them. Folks, we've had a wonderful afternoon out here with Brandon catching some beautiful crappie. It's the sun's up high, it's getting hot, Miss Olivia's hot, and she's getting hungry. What do you say we take it on in? But you only remember, we can only get action like this on
Mississippi Outdoors!
You got it, baby.
Time we'll spend.